tight lap session. He was the fastest car overall. Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh in that messy electric car number 7. Oh, a little bit hard into turn number 3, entering the bottom of turn 4. The car just about got out from under him. Race monitor is up and running. And even with the bobble, that was a good lap. 12.541. And he picks it up to a 4.21. 12.421 for Donald McIntosh in that Blunt Motorsports car number 7. Chad Ogle, former winner here at Volunteer with the Clash, car number 10. He was 9th overall with a 12 and a 9.87. Car number 10 exiting turn number 4, the white flag coming down. A 13.032, just a tick off of his hot lap speed of 12.987. Exiting turn number 3, to the bottom of turn number 4, Chad Ogle in the 10 ride. 6.75, picked it up just over a half a second on lap number 2. So he's within 2/10 of a second from the fast time of Donald McIntosh. 12.421, that's what they're chasing. Car number 11 on the speedway of Marion, Virginia. It's Travis Greer. Good to have our Virginia friends from over in the southwest corner coming down to Henry State to be with us tonight. Car number 11 of Travis Greer. He'll be followed by Anthony Sanders. Travis Greer, 13.089. Anthony Sanders out of line. Mark Douglas coming out before him. So car number 52 is up next. Knoxville, Tennessee, car number 52, Mark Douglas on the speedway. Coming to get his white flag lap. The car came out from under him. Exiting turn number 3 at the entrance of 4. Let's see where he falls in. 12.770, 12 and a 7.70 for Douglas. Here he is entering turn number 3. This time a good exit off of turn number 4. They'll pick it up on lap number 2. Oh, my goodness, what a lap. 12 and a 3.81. He's the fastest time so far. Car number 5. He'll be joined by Anthony Sanders, the Smithfield Barbecue Langley's Collision Center car number 421 out of Spartanburg, South Carolina. Forrest Strand out of Talbot, Tennessee in the 101. He'll roll off from the 15th position. Kevin Wilson out of Stoneville, North Carolina, car number 618, third in the point standings. He goes from 14th. Well, Johnson City, Tennessee's Dale Ball, car number 2, will start from 13th. Points leader Ben Watkins rolls off 12th tonight after some handling problems in the qualifying session. The Sandwood Company, car number 16, starts in 12th. Marion Greer is 11th out of Marion, Virginia. Travis Greer. Ellery Leake out of Knoxville. Joey Coulter out of Union Grove, North Carolina. They're on Periscope tonight. Follow him online if you have a Twitter feed. Download the Periscope app. And race monitor is up and running. Here comes the front row of Mark Douglas and Donald McIntosh. We'll wait for the call to see if this one stands. We may bring them under caution on the back straightaway if they decide to do so. Everything looks green and clear so far. Caution is out. Nope, knew that wasn't going to go. Front row did not come all the way off the corner. The exit of turn number 4, that front row has to start evenly. A little bit too early on the that third row. Chad Ogle, Doug Sanders from row number 4 as the restart for the first lap around Volunteer Speedway. Green is out, underway, and Mark Douglas quickly takes off. Donald McIntosh down to the bottom. Here comes teammate Tommy Kerr out of the inside of turn number 3 to the bottom. Exiting turn 4, Douglas. Let's get them all across, gentlemen. Lap number 1 goes down in the books. Vic Hill in 5th. Mike McCarter up in 4th. Tommy Kerr trying to keep his advance at 51 car down to the bottom. Here they come for lap number 2. Tommy Kerr hangs on to the 3rd place position as we chase down Mark Douglas in car number 52. Sorting out back through the field, watching the cars come up to speed. Ellery Link battling points leader Ben Watkins as Mark Douglas, Donald McIntosh pull away by about 5 car lengths, separated back between the 2. Mike McCarter in 3rd. Vic Hill running the ball. Cannot make the pass on that lap car coming down the front straightaway. Battle for 2nd. Vic Hill underneath the McIntosh. They're tied up behind Big A Anthony Sanders over in turn 2. leader now behind Doug Sanders coming down the front straightaway as they put another lap on Brian Hendricks at five car. He's got lap cars on both sides of him. Sanders now, they'll split shot down the back straightaway. Douglas will clear. He's got some free air in front of him. And now that fierce battle for second, they'll have to maneuver it with two more cars and then some open ground in front of them. McIntosh, he'll turn the car hard down the hill and bring Vic Hill. Matt McCarter, he's got his momentum recapped. The race, that one car has come to life. Up behind the six. Oh, trouble on the front straightaway. Joey Coulter right in front of the field. And Wilson had nowhere to go. I mean, there was nowhere to go. They could not get slowed down fast enough. Vic Hill got tagged. It was minimal, just a little bit of contact. But, you know, these things are so engineered to the nearest degree. I mean, you can't do anything. You can't really touch these things in any fashion. So any kind of contact like that can move a bar. It could move a link, or anything could happen. So let's see if that has affected. The one lap rag for Mark Douglas, car number 52. So in the past, our newest winners on the series come from Volunteer Speedway, and tonight is no different. Knoxville, Tennessee's Mark Douglas wins round five of the Clash at the Gap.